Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing a video about the current banners that are out. That is the Vegito Blue and the Rosé banners, and the JP side, and what banners we have to look forward to. Now this video is unscripted. I figured, you know what, I wanted to do this. I couldn't set anything up last night. I usually will set everything up so that way I can talk about everything in a specific order. Because of my new schedule, when I got home last night, I just said I couldn't do it. I'll set it up the night before, then I'll go in the morning and I'll talk about it. But I was not able to do that, so we're just going to go ahead and wing it today. So right now on the global side of Dokkan Battle, by the way, shout out to dbz.space for all this awesome useful information. This is where we're at right now. As you see over here, we have the Vegito Blue banner and the Rosé banner. Now we're going to open up both of these on the Chrome browser over here. As you see, this is who we have on both of these. You guys are all aware of what's going on. Now, real quick, my opinion on these banners, awesome banners. I think these are phenomenal banners, and I think that especially if you don't have any of the 120 leaders that are listed on both of them, you should definitely summon on them. Now, some of you were following me on Twitter, you would see some posts that I had last night, so go ahead, follow me on Twitter if you want to see those posts, because, man, I was so hyped. I was so hyped. Anyway, so in terms of these two banners, you have some awesome units that you can pull from. The Goku, Super Saiyan 3 Goku, he does have Extreme Z Awakening. He's an awesome unit. Beerus, I don't really like him too much, but if you're a Beerus fan, he is here. Super Saiyan 4 Goku is an amazing unit. He is just a ridiculously hard hitter, and he can tank too after a while, especially if you have some dupe system into him, so you definitely want him. Gotenks is a phenomenal unit. Gohan is also an awesome unit. He's really good. I'm not going to run him as a primary strength unit on a mono strength team, but you can definitely run him on a Hybrid Saiyan team since he's a Hybrid Saiyan leader, which you also need for the Broly event. Vegito Blue obviously is the flagship unit on this banner. Personally, my whole opinion on it is I went extreme only, more for most part anyway, because we do have the LR Vegito Blue, and even though he is better in some scenarios, I have a team cost that can use the LR Vegito Blue. He is easily 100% it. I think that this guy with one dupe path ends up being better than the LR Vegito Blue, I believe, or maybe it's two dupe paths. I forgot, I saw it on the Reddit post. I know he's the 100% Vegito Blue physical is better than this one with this base dupe system in terms of damage output, but I believe with one dupe path, this guy's better than the physical one. With two dupe paths, he's better than LR. But personally, I'm just going to go with LR because I have him, and I'm not going to go hunting for, you know, this guy. In terms of this banner, let's see the leads. You have the 120-17 that's over here. He's a good unit. He's not horrible. He's a good one, especially when you Dokkan Awaken him with that damage reduction. Definitely makes you tank a little bit better. Plus, if you're here for the LR campaign, the LR androids should be 100% it. Goku Black, he has a farmable super attack. Freely farmable super attack. You don't need to pull SRs in order to get him super attack 10. He was very common, at least for me to pull, so I have like all four dupes unlocked. I ended up like Baba-ing him so much because of that. Korra, phenomenal. I love the mono physical team for extreme units, so that's just my thing. Broly, man, he just dropped like crazy for me, but he's good. I know he's one of like the least rated 120 leads out of everyone, but he does hit really hard, so he is a really good unit, especially if you get some key orb manipulators on your team. He can do really a lot of damage. Omega Shenron is another really good unit. He is the Shadow Dragon leader, and you have Rosé. Plus, you have the new Zamasu is good. So honestly, in my opinion, like just like on the hero banner, the Goku Black and the Beerus, two units that I'm not really a big fan of. I'm surprised that they didn't throw the OG Broly on this. I guess it's because his banner's already out. But overall, both these banners have a lot of really good units, so I think both of these are really worth pulling on. So in terms of whether you should summon on it, if you've been saving up your stones, this is probably going to be a good banner. And again, I know it's actually kind of late for me to do this video just because the discounted summons are over, but I want to give my opinion anyway. Now that the spiel's over, let's go ahead and talk about what's to come. So this is the JP side of Dokkan Battle on dbz.space. We had the Bojack thing that came around already. We already have these banners that come out sporadically. We have our Majin Buu, our category lead. We have our Vitara lead. That's with the Kefla. We have essentially all of these side units that have come out. We have the Revival category. We had the Super Saiyan 3 EZA with the Broly in the Cell. Let's see, what else do we have? We're not going to be getting the heroes, or we're probably not going to be getting the heroes. So if we end up getting heroes, that would be phenomenal, but I don't think we are. If we were to, I'd be super hyped because I want those Super Saiyan 3s. Now, this is where we're going into new territory. About 4 months ago, we ended up getting the Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner. Now, I'm a huge fan of Bardock, especially the Super Saiyan 3 variant. So this has not come out yet. Now, there's some speculation he could be next. There might be some others that are next, though. So I don't know what's going on with the Dokkan Fest. We'll have to wait and see. I think that he will be next, just because we already have all the units that are now available for it. The Super Saiyan 3 Goku, and the Angel Frieza. We'll talk about that in a minute. This is going to be the new banners for the World Tournament. I don't believe we're going to get them right away, because they didn't come out until, like, well, we'll see what happens with the banners for the World Tournament. We'll have to wait and see what happens. But this is the new Dragon Ball units that came out. This is the new SSRs that came out with the World Tournament. So we might have some really good units that are coming around. We'll have to wait and see what they actually end up doing with the Global World Tournament. We're getting that physical Trunks, Super Trunks, which I will be doing a review of that in the future. Probably going to be on Thursday. So stay tuned for that. My personal thing that I think, we have the Tapion banner. It has not come to Global yet. I think that we're going to get the Tapion banner next. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I think that that would be the next one. It would kind of make sense, considering they don't want to do two hyped events back-to-back. Again, just an opinion. We don't know. I would say they would do Tapion event. We now have all the growth people who grow in size. That's who he is, the leader, the huge category leader. We had the EZA for Broly. We just had, right now, the Rose and the Vegito Blue are out. So as you see over here, we already have them. Those are the two banners that are out. Let's see over here. We have the Gohan banner. Hold on, Gohan. This is the Hybrid Saiyan banner. We don't need that. This is the non-discounted summon banners for them, too. We had the return of the Tapion banner, or the Tapion stuff. It wasn't actually Tapion. It was part of a celebration that they did. But they were there. And this is going to be part of the third year anniversary. So, honestly, in terms of new units, we really are far ahead of everything that's here. I mean, unless we get special events with all of this filler, in terms of new units, we are really not that far behind the JP side of Dokkan Battle. We have the new boss category that's coming out. I don't think we're going to get that right away. I think since that just came out on Dokkan Battle, I mean, on the JP side, it ended already, actually. It ended today. It looked like it ended today a few hours ago. But the movie boss category, I'm pretty sure that's not coming out. And outside of that, I'm pretty sure that's it. We don't really have anything brand new over here. They just got the Rage Vegeta event and the actual Frieza EZA. So in terms of new banners, unless we get a whole bunch of filler, like how we see over here, it's not really filler. I don't want to call it filler, because like they had the mono banners for all the types for all of the LRs. So like for Majin Vegeta, for Broly, for LR Gohan, and for LR Trunks, Goku Black, if we end up getting that, I mean, I wouldn't be upset. I'm definitely not going to hunt for them. I mean, I already did my thing with this banner. I'm not going to go again until the third year for one of these two banners, but we'll see what happens with that. So honestly, let's go ahead and take a look in terms of these new banners that should be coming out, and whether you should continue to pull on these two banners. Now, personally, the Tapion banner doesn't have anything really good that I think you could get. Like, personally, if this comes out, I want this Goku. This is the only Super Saiyan Goku card that I don't have. I have the OG crossover One Piece event, so I have all of those Gokus waiting for him to increase his Super Attack to 10. I can't wait to free up that space, and I can't wait to get him. Again, only Super Saiyan Goku I don't have. I would love to get this card because of that. But outside of that, I mean, Tapion's cool, but I would never use his leader ability. I don't even think I would summon on his banner unless we got some discounts. Like, here they had the Santa Roshi where you got two Elder Kais when you summoned on it. So maybe I'll do something like that. But we'll see what happens. I don't know. This banner is one that I'm looking forward to. And I kind of think that this one, it's either going to be one of these two next. They're probably going to do Tapion, then they're going to do the Bardock banner. Now, one thing I am upset about, they did not throw Gogeta on this banner. I really wish they threw into Gogeta on this banner, because Bardock is a phenomenal intelligence leader. Not only Super Saiyan 3 leader, but an intelligence leader. With my LR Gohan, I would have loved to have intelligence Gogeta here, because I don't have any Gogeta leader. Especially if we don't get the Heroes banner, you're not going to have the Super Saiyan 3 team like you would on the JP side of Dokkan Battle, which, if you've been following me, I did a couple gameplays, and it's freaking really awesome. But you do have the Bardock, you have Super Saiyan 3 Goku, you have Super Saiyan 3 Broly, you have some support Super Saiyan 3s. Remember, you got the Vegetas, you got the GT variants of these guys, so you do have some options for Super Saiyan 3s. Personally, I would probably run mostly Super Saiyan 3s, and then, like, my LR Gohan, and if I had Gogeta, I'd bring Gogeta as well. This banner is really awesome. You have the defensive Vegeta that should be coming out. You have Janemba if you don't have him. He's also good if you do have him, to feed into the Strength 1 if you don't have the Strength 1, or if you haven't gotten the Strength 1 Super Attack up. This Vegeta's really good. You get two paths unlocked of him, and that's really about it. I mean, the revive freezes on this banner, as you guys probably know, I have not pulled him, so I probably go a little bit ham on this just because I could use dupes of all these. I don't have this Trunks, and I could use dupes of everyone except for, like, the Janemba, and I probably wouldn't. I probably feed in the dupes for Vegeta, but I would never use the dupe system on him. So just really those two. So out of all these, I would like to get all of these guys for dupe system, or for brand new for not having them. But overall, I think that's really it. I mean, we're really close to the JP side. I know I said by April we should be caught up. We're almost there. Again, I don't know if they're going to do a lot of these filler banners. And again, a lot of these filler banners that you see on the JP side over here did coincide with events like the third year anniversary. That's when we had all these specials come out. So we might end up having, like, look at this. This runs until 2/28. And this ran until 3/05. So you had, like, all these LR events that came out with the third year. So we could probably skip all that because that's probably not going to come out to July anyway. By the way, guys, third year on Global is only 2 months away. Keep that in mind. So if you're going to start saving stones, start saving them now. I don't know if the Super Saiyan 3s are going to be, or like the Bardock's going to be on these banners. We'll see what happens. Sometimes they change them. We can go over here real quick and we can take a look. I'll just show you what's on the JP banners in case you guys forgot. So we have the two new Goku and Vegeta base forms. I don't think they're that good. They're just awesome for, like, nostalgia purposes. So it's like Goku and Vegeta's first fight, Goku and Vegeta's second fight. When Vegeta went Majin, Goku was Super Saiyan 2. He held back the Super Saiyan 3. In terms of the unit, you're going to have the Intelligence Goku and Vegeta card, which tokens to an LR. You have the Majin Buu category Vegito. You have the Intelligence Kid Buu, which I personally don't need. I have mine 100%ed. Vegito Blue, again, 100% for me, and Vegito 100% at Buhan, 100% at. So, like, half of these units over here I already have. For you guys who, I don't know if you don't have them, I mean, this is not a bad banner. The free to play, remember, these four units over here, these are not Dokkenfest exclusives, so you can get them off these banners, so you don't really need them. Plus, I think I got them. I did a review of them when they first came out. They're not really that amazing, again, just nostalgia purposes, but this is a really good banner overall, and this is what you have to look forward to. So, you know, if you haven't gotten all the units that you wanted yet, this is what you have to look forward to. In terms of the other banner for the physical Goku and Vegeta, you do have the Gogeta card, you have the Janemba card, you have the Intelligence Gogeta card, Strength Gogeta, and Intelligence Janemba. Now, they kind of did a mix and match over here about who you can and can't run on the different teams, so you need to pull on both banners if you don't have certain units. Personally, I'm probably going to be pulling on this banner myself. This is for, I forgot what card this is actually. Which one is the physical? Did they go to Patara, or are they the fused? Did they do the fusion? Okay, so they do the Gogeta, so they do fusion. I would probably go for this one myself personally. Not just because it's Gogeta, because I do like Gogeta over Vegito, but I would like some dupes of the Intelligence Gogeta. Janemba, I don't have any dupes. Maybe I have one dupe of Janemba. I don't have Gogeta, so this is probably where I'm going to go ham on. These four are going to be available on both sides of the banner, so you just need to, you know, prepare yourself, see what you have, what you don't have. You don't need to go ham right now on the current banners that are out on the global side. So, like, if you're trying to go for super because on the actual super banner because you don't have any of these guys, just remember other units will be available in the future, and while these are all really good, you know, they will be available again on other Dokkenfest exclusives, and you have other units that are either just as good or will be better on other banners, so keep that in mind. Plus, you know, third year anniversary, these LRs are ridiculous. But yeah, guys, we have 2 months to the third year anniversary, so we're probably going to get both these Dokkenfests. There's probably going to be one a month. One's probably going to be the Tapion banner, which I think would be next. I don't know, but it could be next. If not, we're definitely going to get the Bardock banner soon. So that's it, guys. I just want to do a quick overview of the current banner. If you should pull on it, I think you should. Or unless you're waiting for the third year, you can save up for that. But personally, I think this one's definitely worth pulling on. The Super Saiyan 3 Bardock banner also is going to be really worth pulling on, especially if you don't have these units. So I will be doing a little bit of summons on this. I'll probably do about 5 or 6 summons. We'll see what happens. Maybe like 2 videos worth of summons. No guarantees about I'll definitely have my weekly grind out tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to have that in-depth guide for the EZA coming out for the Frieza right away. I kind of want to do an in-depth analysis of the Rose and the Vegito Blue, so that should be coming first. I should also be doing a live stream tomorrow if it's raining and rainy and crappy out and everything. It's currently 12 o'clock and it's a beautiful day out. It's my, technically it's like Saturday. I get 2 Saturdays and a Sunday because of my new schedule. So we'll see what happens tomorrow. But anyway, guys, thanks for stopping by. I have some stuff. Again, if you want to check out what I did on Twitter, go ahead, follow me on Twitter, and you can take a look at some of the stuff I posted from last night. I'm super hyped. But anyway, guys, I'll catch you down in the comments below. Peace.